Hi, good morning, Mimi. It's so nice to see you.
Good to see you too. So let's start with the big story with retail. I mean, how are you dealing with inflationary pressures as you try to balance the needs of the company and the needs of consumers?
Well, yes, as we can see, the rising inflation has caused the prices of our products to increase. However, luckily for Aldi supermarkets, our target income segment begins at the upper middle segment. So they have more of a capacity to absorb any price changes caused by a volatility in the economy. Also, we continue to offer, and our key customers constantly look for unique products driven by value rather than cost. So as long as we continue to offer those products, we are able to cushion the effects of rising prices of our different commodities and stuff and other products.
Are you?
And
No,
also,
go ahead.
yes,
Go ahead.
in order to and also in order to add to the cushioning, or in order to cushion the price volatility in the market today, we at Aldi are constantly looking for ways to make our operations more efficient, as to not further add any additional costs to our consumers.
But Camille, for those who are wondering, with inflation, some people are saying inflation has not yet peaked. Are you seeing more price adjustments towards the back half of the year?
Well, we are optimistic that something can be done. As you can see, our economy is slowly picking up as we continue to open. Our GDP growth is also projected to be higher this year in 2022. So we actually are optimistic about our economic situation this year and in the future. However, there are realities, there are certain conditions around the world that we cannot control. So we are preparing for any price changes or price increases of our products. But hopefully, our efforts in Aldi internally will enable us to sort of cushion the volatility of the prices coming this year.
Camille, I'm very curious. Let's talk about the consumers. What's consumer sentiment and confidence like these days? I mean, when they look at how far their peso can go, are you seeing new trends and patterns when they shop in your stores, like maybe flight to bulk or more people doing bulk buying? Is there trip consolidation? Are they having to, trade down purchases? Or as you mentioned, you're catering to the upper middle income, so maybe not so much.
We're seeing that our consumers have actually increased in basket size, albeit less frequent trips to the supermarket. But we noticed, starting last year and until now, we have an increase in our basket size. So we see that our consumers are stocking up on items. And however, what we have seen in the past months and starting the second quarter is really the beginning of what they call revenge retail. So it seems that a lot of people, or a lot of our consumers, have come back to our supermarkets. They are looking for more products and looking again to the experiential nature of their shopping trip. Because before, a lot of us really stayed home and did a lot of online shopping, which actually caused us to accelerate our digitalization in Aldi to address those needs. But now we are seeing a balance between people who are online shopping and who are dependent largely on digital platforms, as well as people coming back to our brick and mortar stores for a premium shopping experience. So that is what we have noticed with consumer behavior. Actually, we are very happy because we have seen that despite uncertainty, despite changes in the price of goods, we have actually experienced an increase in our sales, more people coming back, more people buying more items at the supermarket.
Exactly. I mean, you've had a pretty good run in the first quarter, profit up 33% to 95 million. You're talking about a revenge retail. I imagine it's just beginning. So what's the trajectory like for the rest of the year? How optimistic are you? What sort of expansion and growth are you seeing?
Well, we're looking at about between a 20 to 30% annualized core net income growth. And we're also looking at a sizable increase in our revenues. We are also well on target to achieving 100 stores by 2026. Currently, we have 35 stores and are well on our way to meeting our pipeline for the year 2022.
Very aggressive expansion plans indeed. And you're going to be focusing on still Metro Manila and first tier cities?
Yes, all our growth in the near future will be stores in Mega Manila and in first-tier cities in municipalities around the Philippines.
I know that you have an in-store brand. Are you looking to grow that segment? And if so, to contribute what percentage to sales?
Well, year on year, we plan to double or increase the share of sales of our in-house brand. Right now, we're focusing on products that are commonly used in the households, and we will continue to increase the product lines till the end of this year. Currently, we're more focused on dry goods for our items, and we're well on our way to doubling our share or of sales of our in-house brand, and we believe that this trend will continue more so in the future.
Mm-hmm. Camille, let's talk about taxes, because the incoming Marcos administration is under pressure to raise revenues, and one of the ways, you know, to pay for the mounting debt, and among those proposed would be to roll out new taxes or maybe repeal some tax exemptions. How do you view this? How do you see these tax policy changes, if they happen? You know, what do you expect them to make a significant dent on consumption? You are a lawmaker yourself. What is your perspective on this?
Well, in terms of the taxes that may be necessary, I think one of the key things that we should look at is really to lessen the effect to most of the consumers. So perhaps we can be creative in which industries and which particular segments we can tax, and not pass it on to the consumers and to a majority of the population, of which it will be creating a big effect on their spending. So I think that is one of the considerations when creating policies regarding taxes, is to not affect most of the people or a majority of our population, especially the population in which the cost of goods is very has quite an effect. So I think that's something that we will look at. And in terms of the effect on consumption, on our consumers, we are still very optimistic that they will still continue to spend as they have been in the past. And there are many, many different ways to cushion any price increases. Like on all these parts, we are trying to make our operations more efficient. Mm-hmm. We are constantly looking for ways to reduce costs in our operations, as to not further add on to the volatile prices of items caused by outside factors and caused by our economy.
Mm-hmm. Final question, and I want to end on the big picture. You know, we always look at All Day as part of a growing empire of your father, of your family, Mr. Manny Villar, of course, the country's richest man. What's next, Camille? I'm sure you have this interesting conversation at home or with the family. What's next for the group? I mean, you're in real estate, you're in property development, you're in retail. Where will the next leg of growth come from, you think? What's the next trick up your sleeve?
Well, we believe, you know, all of our products, whether it is in housing mm-hmm. or in retail, whether it's in home lines or even grocery items, all of our products and all of our offerings have really set to give a premium offering to the market. And as we can see, although we have been temporarily set back by the effects of the COVID-19 pandemic, mm-hmm. revenge retail has returned, and it has done so in all the industries. We are very happy about the increase in revenues in the second quarter, both in our retail offerings as well as our real estate sales. We're very optimistic about what lies ahead, and we will continue to serve premium products and to offer premium products to the consumers, because we believe that our GDP is growing very fast, and as this continues, the Filipino consumer will be more discerning, and will continue to be more discerning. We'll continue to look for premium products, premium places to go, and this is something that we feel that they deserve and that we will continue to offer. So we believe that our strategy about which income segment to focus on, we are right on track to achieving our goals.
All right. Final question. Any plans to raise funds via the capital markets or bonds?
Currently, for All Day, a lot of our expansion is being financed by our IPO, which was in November 2021. Mm. And so any growth for All Day, a supermarket, will be financed by that and our operating cash flows.
All right. On that note, thank you very much, Camille, for joining us this morning. Have a great weekend. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mimi. Have a good day.